Hi guys, welcome back to Fisher Lover Issue. Today, we're going to learn about history, the history of aquaculture that you should know and appreciate. As we know, the meaning of aquaculture is self-explanatory. The term aquaculture refers to the propagation of aquatic organisms in the water for diverse purposes, including protein source, medication, pets, and recreation, and these make aquaculture the contrast to the capture fisheries where harvesting wild aquatic organisms is involved. How did it all begin? So here I would like to talk about brief history of aquaculture technology and some thoughts about where it might go in the future. It all began in 6000 BC when the native Australian called Gunditjmara from Victoria, Australia was recorded to have built a channel and dams to capture and preserve eel to be eaten all year round. They constructed an elaborate system of trap to capture the eels and will be available at all times. During 2500 BC, common carp was the earliest to be propagated by the Chinese, where they are trapped in lakes and fed with silkworm nymphs. During the Tang Dynasty, the culture of carp has been banned due to the Chinese word for carp that sounds almost similar to Emperor's family name Li. However, these incidents did not stop the enhancements of carp breeding as genetic mutation brought the production of goldfish during the Tang Dynasty. The Romans were the first recorded to culture fish in Europe for their consumption whenever they want. They love marine fish and they love oyster. So they began developing oyster farm that was brought into Italy from all parts of the empire. The Romans also adopted Egyptian Assyrian vivarium, a tank that sized as a bathtub to place the cod fish alive until the time to eat them. This culture only available in wealthier homes where guests could choose any fish that they fancy at the current time. It is believed that the early Christian monarchies adopted the Roman aquaculture practice and spread into Europe during the Middle Age. In the Renaissance era, freshwater fish farming was further developed with carp dominating many important rivers in Europe. And the beginning of salmon and trout breeding was recorded during 18th centuries, where a German scientist named Stephen Ludwig Jacobi successfully bred salmon and trout through external fertilization. In 1871, the National Fish Hatchery has been developed in the United States through U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service Administration. During those times, many spawning stations were built for collecting and hatching of fish eggs to reduce the dependency to wild-caught fish. This movement has initiated the formation of the first hatchery known as Baird Hatchery, which was primarily handling salmon production and shipped the eggs so that salmon could be available for all. Since then, aquaculture continuously to develop and more cultured species were attempted to be bred and supplied from freshwater, brackish water and even mariculture. And currently, aquaculture is moving towards eco-friendly and sustainable practice to satisfy the ever-growing seafood demand without destroying the environment. More advanced technologies, including land aquaculture, offshore farming, aquaponic system for small producers have been adopted to reduce the greenhouse effect as well as producing more sustainable products. With the right approach in research and development and commitment from the industry, I believe the trend of sustainable aquaculture is promising. What do you guys think? Did I miss anything? If I did, please feel free to add more on the comment section. Share and thumbs up this video if you like and subscribe if you'd like to hear more about this. So with that, thank you for watching and see you next time.